I made it through. Sight of the storm and rain, heartache and pain. Still I'm declaring I made it through. See, I didn't lose. Experience loss at a major cost. But I never lost faith in you. So if you see me cry, it's just a sign that I'm still alive. Oh yeah, I got some scars, but I'm still alive. In spite of calamity, he still has a plan for me. And it's working for my good, and it's building my testimony.
So glad I made it.
Is there anybody in here have that testimony?
I made it through.
I made it through.
In spite of the storm.
In spite of the storm.
I made it through.
I'm still alive. So glad I made it. I made it through. I made it through.
So glad I made it.
Thank you, Jesus.
So glad I made it.
I could have lost my mind. I could have lost my mind.
I made it through.
But I made it through.
I made it through.
I wish I had a witness. Is there anybody in here that's been through anything?
So glad I made it.
That you almost threw in the towel.
I made it through.
But when you look back over your life, you realize I made it there. 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 Is there anybody in here that
see what you have for us in that, God. Oh God, let us walk in it, God. And let us talk in it, God. And most of all, let us have faith to believe your word, God. And let us stand in it in the name of Jesus, God. And we thank you, God. And we give you praise, God. And we lift you up and magnify you forever and ever and ever. Amen, amen, amen. Hallelujah. As the praise team makes their way up. Hallelujah, God. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord God.
Hallelujah. Come on, let's give God another praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. God is so amazing. His love for us is so amazing. He's just an amazing God. Everything that he does seems to amaze me. Because you can ask God for one thing, and then it just seems like he just gives you so much, more than what you need. All the time. We serve a good and mighty God. Even when we don't deserve it, he still blesses us and keeps us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And he loves us.
Amen.
And he never changes. He's not wishy-washy. He's always the same. And that is amazing. Because we look at ourselves and we see how we can get so moody, so irritable. We're up one minute, we're down the next minute. But aren't you glad that you know somebody and found somebody? Hallelujah. That always remains the same. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
It's so amazing.
grateful to be here and give God some praise. Don't you love him on tonight? Don't you love him on tonight? Don't you love him? Give him praise. Let him see how much you love him. Love is an action word. Hallelujah. Come on. Let's give him praise. He deserves it. He deserves it. Hallelujah. If we can walk into the courthouse and honor the judge when he tells us to stand, if we can go to the football field and cheer and yell for our favorite team, why can't we come into the house of the Lord and scream and give a praise at the top of our lungs? Hallelujah. He's our source. He's our keeper. Even when we don't want to be kept.
Thank you. Thank you. God glory. Amen. Amen. We're glad to be in the house of the Lord one more time. Amen. Amen. Hope you're glad to be in the house of the Lord one more time. As your pastor said, we don't deserve it. Amen. We don't get a lot. We don't get what we deserve. Amen. He gives us more. Amen. That's what grace is. That's what grace is. One of you, but I'm going to ask you to spend 1 minute to go and hug someone this evening. Just spend 1 minute to go hug someone.
March 17th, we'll have a Purim service. March the 27th through 29th, 9, Urgent Care 1 in Lexington. Joy is supposed to meet with the praise team after service. We have baptism on Sunday, 8:30.
Also on the 29th, the praise team will be going to Mount Moriah Church in Mebane, North Carolina. Is that correct?
Amen.
And then they're going to be there at Mount Moriah on the 29th, I believe, is that what it is?
And First Baptist at noon. Mount Moriah at 5, First Baptist at 11. And on March the 15th, we have to go and sing at Ebenezer.
All right, praise the Lord. Turn up the praise team and get the word out. And about the Lord. Also on March the 30th, I believe, Kenny and I will be in Atlanta. I will be ministering in Atlanta on that particular weekend.
The prayer line tomorrow from 9 to 10.
Thank you. Amen. We continue again with the service. I'm going to ask if Minister Robert Beard to come give us scripture at this time.
Glory to God. Are you ready to all come to that? Turn the song still to him.
Father, in the gracious name of Jesus, we
thank you and praise you right now for your goodness and for your mercy, Father. Because it could have been another way, Father. Lord, we thank you right now for the hallelujah, protecting us over the highways, Father. Hallelujah, Jesus. Leading us to the house of prayer tonight, Father God. We thank you right now, Lord Jesus, for how you furnish our food for us, Father God. Hallelujah, Lord. You give us the activities of our limbs, Father. Oh, God, it's shaped in your son. For Lord, there is so many, Father. Ha, God, it's they did not wake up this morning, Father God. Oh, that seat of the shunder, God. Oh, that seat of the shunder, God, your seat. We hold everything that you've given to us, everything that you're going to give us, close to our hearts, Father. Lord, we thank you right now, hallelujah, Lord, because you're worthy of all honor and all praise, Father. Oh, that's you giving us, Father. There is none like you, Lord. He did his son of world seek this. He shed more of son now. We ask you right now to be in the midst of this service, Father. Let our hearts be open to receive, Father. What says the Lord? Hallelujah. Glory to your name, Lord Jesus. We ask you right now, hallelujah, to bless our homes, bless our families, Father God. Bless those who wanted to be here on tonight, Father God, but could not be here, Father. But bless them, Father. Hallelujah, Lord. Let whatever we receive on tonight from you, Lord. Hallelujah. That they receive it as well, Father. Glory to your name, Lord. We just thank you right now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And these and all other blessings, Lord, that we give unto you. Hallelujah, Jesus. In the name of Christ Jesus of Nazareth. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen. At this time, again, as Diddy always says, is a time where everybody can participate.
Yep.
Amen. It's also, you know, I'm a country boy, so I have to relate things back to the farm. So it's also a time that we can expect harvesting. Amen. Because when you sow seeds, amen, you reap a harvest. Amen. That's just the fact of the matter. Sowing brings harvesting. Amen. And when you're working with God, amen, you're working with, I say it, a certified investor. Amen. He's one that's not going to put interest on what you give him. Amen. What you give him, he makes it excel and makes it grow. Amen. And he doesn't ask for it back except for what? For the 10%. Amen. Amen. But at this time, again, we're going to ask the financing people who can come forth as we get ready to sow seeds. Amen. Amen. If you need an envelope or
Word that multiplied, Lord God.
start, okay? Amen. Because I had four things. Amen. Alright. Let me make sure I can remember. Alright, so number one, the first thing that happened was after we got out of here, I had to go do homework. Alright? Which really sucks. I'm so glad we made class. But I got to the school and got everything. My testimony for that is that I got everything done. Amen. Even though it was 2:30, amen, when I got it done, it was completed, amen. Amen. And then secondly, the thing that goes behind that is that I wasn't able to print it at that time, amen. And again, I was running on 3.5 hours of sleep because I got up, you know, to go to class. My class starts at 8. But I got up to go print it, and it still wouldn't print today, all right? And so I'm thinking to myself, oh my gosh, because my teacher, she's this pregnant lady, she's very pregnant, so I deal with emotions every day with her. But she thankfully, she said, it's okay. And that was, you know, that was a testimony to me because, you know, this is God's grace. It seems long, you know, it's a big thing to me. She's the way it is. The first day of class, she cracked me down for having my phone out in class, so it was a testimony for me. But third thing, all right. So I get, again, these are small things to me. I mean, these are big things to me. It might take things longer, but big things to me. When I get home, I was really hungry, okay? And I had eaten more of the leftovers than I thought I had eaten, okay? So it was like a handful of leftovers that was left because I had eaten more than what I thought I had eaten. But I get home, and I'm like, I'm just thinking to myself, okay? I didn't speak nothing out loud. I was just speaking. So I get home, I pour the sauce, like two spoonfuls of sauce over the pasta. I eat that. I'm thinking to myself, God, I'm still not satisfied. And so then I drink two things of water to try to, you know, get fuller. Still not there. All right. But then I hear an elder come through the door, and I was gonna show her how to close the door the right way because the cold air would come through the door sometimes. And so I was gonna show her. So I got down there. And I got ready to open the door, and I see her coming through, but I didn't see what was down. Okay? I was just looking up at her. And she's like, boy, can you help me bring these two bags? And when I looked, it was two bags of chicken. Amen. Chicken, potatoes, and coleslaw. Amen. Double of each. Amen. So we had enough for apostle, evangelist, for daddy and me. Amen. Now, like I said, that might seem small, but it was a big thing for me because God was reading my mind with the small things. Amen. So I was just thankful for that. Amen. So, anybody else got a testimony?
I just want to stand and give God glory for it. I went to the doctor this week a couple of times. I've been getting some good reports. I've got an appointment for tomorrow to look at the results. I had some work done on my heart to see what's going on with my heart. They took some pictures and stuff. And one thing I never realized is how pretty the eyeball can look when you take a picture of it. I took a picture of my eyeballs, and I said, wow. None of the veins were broken or busted or anything, so your eyes are in good shape. I said, well, thank you.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Amen.
Glory to God, apostle, wife. Because everybody here.
Amen.
I feel like Rhea said, my little small thing is big to me. I thank God today because we did get out of here late. We cleaned and everything. And I had to study for a 100 question test in nursing. And I was like, when we got home, I told my husband, I said, I'm tired. I'm going to sleep. So I prayed and I said, God, I said, you're going to have to help me bring everything back to my remembrance. So my body was really tired. And I just want to say that I did make a 93 on my test. I am so grateful. And I do want to tell another testimony about them thoughts. Because the day before yesterday, we went to the store. And I had left my wallet home. And we went to Harris Teeter. I went to get some baked chicken. Because their baked chicken is really good. So when I looked in my bag, I was like, oh my goodness. I left my wallet home. But I did have $10. I said, well, I need to get two packs of chicken. It's $4.99 for 8 pieces. I said, I really want this chicken. So I told my husband, I told my son, I said, well, I'm gonna go in there, And whatever else needs to be added to this is going to be added.
Amen.
Will, I'm going to find something that's going. So I get inside. There was no chicken. I said, I can't believe the lady was like, after the snow days, people call in now to get the chicken. So I said, okay. So I went looking. I said, what am I going to get to feed four people with $10? Right. So I went over to the deli. Oh, thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
When I went over to the deli, I saw Miss Mary's beautiful face. She said, I came to get that chicken. They don't even have that chicken. She said, well, you tried their meat. Their meat is very good. So I said, yeah, I used to get the turkey with her. Make a long story short. I said, well, what you got on sale? Because I have $10. I need to get enough meat to feed four people. And I got to get some cheese. And I got to get some bread. So she was like, well, let me see. So she said, well, we got some turkey pastrami on sale. I said, turkey pastrami? I said, okay, that's good. I said, because we can't beef, so turkey pastrami. Lord forgive me if it is, it ain't beef, it ain't red meat, it's turkey pastrami. So I said, oh, thank you, Jesus. I said, okay, give us that. Then when she gave it, so she put a little, okay, she put it, that was, okay. So then she put the cheese. She said, oh, Lord. I said, now look, let me tell you, you gotta know how to stretch it. I said, can I have $3 worth of cheese? Because you get a lot of cheese. You get a lot of cheese. So I said, what do you mean? I'm probably going to eat one sandwich. They eat two just for tonight. So she's putting up, she said, oh, Lord, I put too much cheese. I said, now, Miss Mary, you know, you got $10. Miss Mary said, baby, why don't you let me just buy the bread for you? I said, you know what, Miss Mary, I'm going to learn how to take my blessing. Yes, you can buy the bread. So we went and got the bread, and let me tell you, I thank God for that blessing because we was able to eat. And he sent a ram in the bush.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
I do want to give honor to my Lord and Savior, which is Jesus Christ, to the Chief Apostle Blackwell, to Apostle Brandon, to his beautiful wife, to every heart he and available. You know, I just thank and praise God. I thank and praise him for his spirit. I thank and praise him for this ministry. Because on today, the Spirit of God began to speak to me in a different way and to show me and the ministry. I had went downtown to pay the taxes for my car. So I was pulling in the street. You know, I turned in to where I live. I live on the cul-de-sac. And there was a black car behind me and it pulled in too, but it went around the circle. So I pulled in the driveway, and this young man by the stairs, he stopped, and he said, hey, how you doing? I said, I'm doing fine. And he just kept talking. I didn't know him. So then I started walking towards him. So he said, are you doing all right? And I said, yes. So he said, well, you know, I heard that you was a person that I could talk to. I said, yes. And I'm sitting. So then he went on to say how he had just gotten out of the hospital and how he was shamed by some things and type of surgery he had. So he said, well, can I talk to you? And I said, yes. So he began to talk to me about a lot of personal matters and the surgery that he would need. So then I asked him, I said, well, do you know Jesus as your Lord and Savior? He said, yes. So I said, let me have your hand. And I began to pray with him for his healing. And I began to speak into his life. So he said, well, thank you very much. And he said, well, I'm going to let you know how I turn out. So I said, okay. So before he left, he said, how old are you? And I guess the reason why he asked me that, because he had told me all this personal stuff about his life. So I told him my age. So he smiled. He said, thank you. So then he went on. So my grandson, he was standing, you know, in the driveway. He said, Mom, who is that man? I said, I don't know. He said, what you mean you don't know? I said, I do not know him. So this is what God gave me. He said, your ministry is not in the four walls.
That's right.
Your ministry, he said, it's okay to pray, mm-hmm. to prophesy, and to teach. Mm-hmm. But your ministry is not in the four walls. Yes. And another thing he said was, is just like John the Baptist. They are coming to you. You do not have to go to them. So prepare yourself. Listen to the apostle. Listen to the Holy Spirit so that God can get the glory.
Amen.
Because he wants us to minister to the masses.
Amen.
And the masses, they are not in the church.
Amen.
They are outside of these walls. And I thank you for my teaching, because before, you know, the only thing I thought about was teaching in church, interceding for the church. But God said, it's more to a ministry than that.
Hallelujah.
And this is what I have ordained you for. This is what I have equipped for. And I'm so blessed. So we at Pinnacle, we're going to have to take it to the masses.
Amen.
And when you walk out these doors, the people, they're going to find you. And God will get the glory.
Amen.
I'll be very brief. My first testimony is to be able to come up in here tonight and know that I didn't worry. I was rested to know that everything would be going well, because I'd asked my son to be in charge. Amen.
Amen.
So that's a testimony for you to be moving like you're moving tonight. I thank God for that. When we talk about things that may look small to others. Second thing that is that I know it's a hard time for everybody. And so it had been a difficult time for us as well. We do well, but you know, we have situations that we're coming about not only doing. So we had to go to, this weekend, we went to Waystar. And someone told me, they said, well, have you noticed your tags on your car? And I've been driving around for, I guess, 3 or 4 weeks with the tags expired, right? So, and it had January, so you know, they give you 15 days, but you know, next week, in a whole month of grace. But anyway, so I said, Lord, when I got this, I said, God, I need to get my tags. I know I got to pay my taxes. I need to make sure. I said, God, you know, I got some other things that are pressing, and I don't know how I'm going to get this money to do that. And so I was called in early this morning, funeral home. I was not dressed, and I was in the funeral home all day long. But God had me undressed to really be able to do some work. And that work was, is that the family that came in today, because we had a funeral, they were very pleased, but they turned around and ordered like 8 blankets from us today. 8 blankets. That's, we never had an order of 8 blankets. But what happened was, they turned around and wanted flowers. I just happened to have 3, but they wanted them reworked. I said, well, what it did was, she said she wanted a flower down on the floor. So I said, well, I got some back here but you might can use. She said, but I want baby's breath in. I said, well, I can put baby's breath in. And I put baby's breath in it. That flower sold for $85. The next person came back and said, well, I want the $125 wreath. The next one came back and said, well, I want the other wreath. Can you do that for $65? So when I get, I went to the DMV, and then when I got there, they said, well, you know, you owe taxes from last year, you gotta go pay. I said, Dad, I just bought the car in January last year. I don't know when y'all know this or not now, but you pay your taxes in advance,
yeah.
Not afterwards, then, if you pay them in advance. So I went to DMV, she said, well, we're going to charge you a late charge. We're going to charge you $28 late charge. We've got a $20 fee, late charge, taxes, go get your taxes. Oh, by the way, go get your car inspected. But you know what? But what I sold those flowers for, I was going to do all of it and have some of that. It's not look like it's been for you. But when God can meet your need, because he knew that he did not want Lorraine and I going down the road and didn't have and then expired tags on the car. And God just took care of that. And I'm saying to you, if you just be honest with God and tell him what you need, he will supply you.
Amen.
Thank you, Father God, for being here. To Apostle Drayton, to Apostle Drayton's wife, to everyone that is in here on tonight. I just thank God for being here, and I thank God for the revival. My testimony may not seem much to y'all, because it's small. But when we was praying for the apostle and his wife, I didn't feel a little something in the way. But when I came out, and I came and I sat down, it was like such a peace that just fell on me and in me. And it was just so amazing. And I'm like, God, thank you so much. And even what happened even on last night, how the Lord spoke last night to me,
when I got back home, I was just telling the Lord, thank you. And I was just telling us, Lord, let you know I need to be home today. I don't need to go to work. I just need to just stay home, because every time I begin to tell the Lord, thank you, tears just begin to roll down from my eyes. And then when I got at work, and my little work, I just begin to pray. And then I begin to feel dots. And I had to fight at work. And I had to bind up some spirits. Then I got here tonight. I sure don't have much. Even trying to sing and give God some praise, I had to bind a spirit in the house of God. It ought not to be so. But I had to bind it. And I don't know if y'all saw what I did, but I cut my hand and I.
Amen.
I had to throw that spirit out that was coming up against me, and it's coming. And I'm like, God, I need for you to deal with this. Deal, because I'm sick of it. Deal with this. Yes. We have to be honest.
Go ahead, man.
I want him to deal with it. Because enough. It is enough. And I've had it. Enough of that spirit coming from that individual. Enough is enough. But I bless him for the freedom now that I feel. And I bless him for it. And if I'm out of order, you can deal with me. I will receive it. But I had to get that.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Amen.
I give honor to God, my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I want to give honor to the apostles and ministers in the building, everybody that came. We'll go ahead and sit down. Because what I'm about to tell you is really personal. But I'm glad that I let it go. Because for once in a long time, my family is an actual family now that I let this go. But at the age of 14, just starting high school, I was going to this church. And, you know, I played the drums, I sang for them, and everything. And we went to Atlanta to shoot a video. And my friend's mom was friends with my mom, so I went to go talk to her. And, you know, get stories on my mom, see how they have fun. And it was a guy on a laptop. I didn't know him. And he said, come here, I want to talk to you. And I said, okay. Because I didn't want to be mean or rude. So I went over there to him. He said, I want to show you something. What he showed me was something I ain't never seen before. It was an adult film. And he said, you got an erection. I said, no, I've never seen anything like this before. So basically, he molested me. And he molested me. When I knew what to do, I got up and tried to run. And he blocked my way, and he forced me to watch it. So I stopped going to that church. I stopped singing. I stopped playing the drums for him. And basically, I just shut myself out from the world. I didn't even tell my mom or nothing. And until I was 18, I told him, and now I'm closer than ever with my mom. But now I stand before you, 20 years old, and with many talents, many gifts, all due to God. And at one point in my life, it was I was figuring, why me, God? Why do I get all of this? And there are other people who deserve it more than me. But now I see that that he saves his stronger battles for his stronger warriors.
That's what deliverance feels like. Deliverance feels like.
went to God, and I guess I didn't realize I had a testimony until I started listening to everybody else. But I had to deal with some financial things, and a lot of times I didn't say, I would just share, especially at work. You know, with my aunt, I said, you know, this is late fee for this, and this late fee for that. And by the end of the month, it could add up to so much. And it happened because we changed our pay cycle. But I'm like, it's just a trick of the enemy. So I decided to make an appointment to go talk to these people. And I didn't even tell them about it because the news don't think, oh, let's pray. But I went today, and my family didn't know about this. And we talked about those late fees. So for the next few months, there will be late fees, but it's not going to go towards other charges. It's going to go towards the bill. And then, like, after the 3-4 months, I'll be ahead. And I'm about to go. Some upgrades and stuff. So God is good.
Glory to God.
Amen. Good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
Giving honor to God, Apostle, and all the hearts in the building. Oh, I sound a little tired. But I'm excited to be here tonight. I wasn't here last night. For those of you know, I did start my new job, and I get up at 1 and have to be at work at 2 in the morning. So I went in this morning, and there's like a long list of everything that I have to get done by 7 before we open. So I was putting this bread in the oven on this rack, and when I put it, I was putting it in the oven and it got stuck in the oven. I'm like, oh God. And I didn't know how to do it. I was like, Lord, you want to give me the strength to work this out. And it already started to turn, so it was like literally stuck in the oven. I'm like, I'm the only one here at 2:00 in the morning. And I don't have nobody to call, nobody to help me. So I was like, oh God, you have to give me strength. So then I got this bright idea the Lord gave me. He's like, well, just take like half of it and put it on this other rack. I burned myself in the process, but it's good. So I took half of it off and put it on the rack. And then I was like, okay, so we'll see if this works. And then I pushed and it went all the way in. I was like, oh, thank God. So that little small thing, like, it took me 30 minutes. But I did finish everything that I needed to do. So I didn't hear anything from the boss. And I got compliments from my boss today. She's like, oh, I'm very impressed with you. She's like, I'm not used to having somebody for such a small person to be doing so much. It's in like 50 pounds of flour and all these big boxes. I was like, yeah, that's God, because it is so hard waking up in the morning and I'll be so restless. But thank God, just give me the strength to do it. And school and homework. I'm just excited to be here. Like, I woke up for school in the morning. I'm not even worried about it. I'm just glad to be here tonight. So.
I just want to thank the Lord for even being here. I did Apostle Terry today, and I'm telling you, I was telling him about being sick yesterday. I had gone to Atlanta for the hair show, and I get so much and so quickly. And by the time I got back, I was sick. I was so sick that I said yesterday, well, I'll just go to bed. And I know I'm going to be so sick tomorrow that I won't be able to get out of bed. And I'm telling you, when I got to my dad's house, we just started selling this new product, and it's called Forever Living. And I was like, no one's ever heard of this, you know, but he gave me the product. He gave me the pills, the aloe, and I took his. And by the time I got to Burlington from Warrensville, my headache was gone.
Amen.
I was feeling better.
And
I just felt like a new person. And even though I was so sick. When I woke up this morning, I wasn't sick anymore.
Amen.
And I was so excited. I'm the Healer. He will heal you. And you know it's supernatural when you know before you've been sick. And it lasted longer, but God will supernaturally heal you. And when I got to the salon, Tom told me this testimony about the lady who came in. She was from Tanzania, from Africa. She told me that she saw the bottle that I had on my counter of aloe. She said that her sister had cancer, stage 2. And she took that in Africa. They paid like $50 for it, and she hadn't seen it since. And when she saw it in my salon, she was just so excited. She said, we don't even know what we have. somebody, because I'm walking in my healing. I'm still in a ways to go. Please pray for me, because I know I'm kind of a little ill, but every day is better than that.
Praise God for being here tonight. And I thank God so much for being here, because this morning, the transportation service that brings me, they came to me this morning, and he said that they had to cap my time. So because I got out so late last night, and they said, we have to get you by 9 o'clock, Liam, you know, pick up at 9 o'clock. But you know what? It's okay, because I just thank God that they didn't say we couldn't pick you up.
Come on.
So I'm just grateful to be here, because God has made a way. Even though I'm in the facility where I'm at, I just thank Him for being able to come here and be with everybody and see everybody's smiling face every time I come. It just gives my heart joy. I just thank Him for that.
Amen.
First, giving them honor to my God, who's first in my life.
All right,
then. Last night, I told Greer yesterday, I said, I will see you tonight. I got up on my bed last night, and I said, my shoulders is hurting me. My back is hurting me. I can't go nowhere tonight. So I didn't come last night. So I got home today. And I started the same thing. You gotta cook you something to eat. You ain't hungry. I need to fix something to eat. You ain't hungry. I said, I ain't think I'm gonna go, because I be late in the morning for work. So I said, you get up. I sit down. So I said, go now. You promised Greer you was coming. So I called Greer and I said, Greer, what time the service start? The speaker speak. He said, why? I said, I want to know. You said, it started before the end. And something else he said, I didn't pay no attention to. This is my grandson, my adopted grandson. So I didn't pay any attention to him. What he was saying, and anyway, I said, I'm not going tonight. I'm coming tomorrow night. And the boss spoke to me and said, do I ever be late for you?
Amen.
Do I ever be late for you?
Amen.
And I said, no. Get up and go.
Yeah.
And here I am.
Yeah, have any more testimonies? Any more passing balls?
You know, I thank God. I have been praying, because you all know where seasons of Lebanon is taking me.
Amen.
And I'm like, Lord, I just need someone to help to drive, to stay on the road. And Lavonnie had volunteered to take me back and forth to my therapy.
Amen.
But then she had been telling a 93-year-old apostle who is at Grind Center about me. And she said, bring her by. I want to talk to her. So we went by last Thursday. And when I walked in, she said, I told Lavonnie to get her chauffeur's cap, because God wants her to be on this mission with you for the seniors. And I just said, and she began to just ask me, said, do you pastor? And I said, yes. And then she began to tell me different things that God was going to do in my ministry. And I went back and I said, Lord, I thank you. Because I just feel like sometimes things get at a standstill and you're just wondering, Lord, am I hearing what you are saying? But I just thank God that he sent someone that I didn't even know to come by and let me know that I was on the right track.
Amen.
And what God was going to do through Cedars of Lebanon. And I just want to give God the glory.
Amen.
Because he does this thing.
I was going to be quiet, but you know, I just sat there and listened to everybody, and then, you know, I just talk about that voice. Small things, you know, you got to be grateful for what God does for you. I just started this job not too long ago, and it's kind of hectic, it's strenuous on the body, and you know, you do a lot of stuff. But, you know, when you work, you do everything to the best of your ability, and you do it unto the Lord, not unto people, because some of the people that I work under, they can be vicious towards people, and they're real short of temper. So, some situations was happening on the job, and I'm diligent at what I do. So, what happened was, and I know who it was my boss, the one that everybody points the finger at. She sent me over to the other side yesterday of the building to work over there. And when I was on the other side of the building, they shut down my whole line and shift everybody's schedule. So, people got to work overnight and second shift. And God hid me. He covered me for just being diligent and doing the things that I gotta do.
Hey.
So God will have me. And listen, so I'm able to come to service. I'm able to do everything I gotta do. And I'm in a different position where I got more exposure to get maybe what I might want. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. God glorious. Anyone else?
I just want to give God the glory today that I'm here. You all have been a really great blessing to me, and I have really and truly had so much anxiety, and the devil's been on me all day. He's talking about call, you're not going to go. Well, you can't make it, you can't go. And I just thank God that I'm here today for the blessing that you all have given me tonight. So thank you.
Well, everybody know that my grandson is 7 years old, and he is the man of my life. That's the best of my life. And so his mother had went somewhere, and he's a very small little fellow, but he's on after school care, and he's not supposed to catch the bus home. But for some reason, he caught the bus home. And they're in Atlanta, and when he caught the bus home, nobody was at home. So he walked around in an apartment complex by himself. And you know, and telling me something like that, you know, I'm getting ready to go tell him. Simple as that, I'll just go get him. But the maintenance man that know him, because they're very, you know, open kids, they're very open people. He saw him walking, he was like, Mario, where are you going? And he got him so that, you know, because somebody could have got him.
Amen.
Because he's only 7. And somebody could have picked him up, but he wandered around in the apartment complex. And so he got him and he called his mother and told her that I got Kamari. And so by then, you know, all of us was crying. We all crying. I'm well here in Brooklyn, I'm crying. Everybody crying because just to think about that, somebody could have snatched him. But because we pray, and because I tell him, I said, regardless of what, you know, make sure God is first in your life. And so because we were, you know, because that guy came and picked him up, he called his mother, he said, don't worry about it, I got it. But we thought about what could have happened.
Amen.
And so we knew that it was a God sent.
Amen.
Because at 7 years old, in Atlanta, you don't know anybody. Anybody could have picked him up. So I give God the praise for the guy's name is D. They call him D. And I give God the praise for D because he got my grandson. And not only that, I ask God to bless him above and beyond. Because if something has happened to that little boy, we, but I thank him. But thank God for that.
Amen. Is that all?
Amen. I may be alone, and I just thank the Lord for you being here, being waked up this morning. And I went to the doctor, and the doctor said, my eyes are just as good, so don't come back in a year.
Amen. 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 Is everyone good? Amen. Well, we will continue. Oh, Miss Mike.
How are you? The thing that I should. And, you know, I've given off the apostle and to the pastor, the pastor, visiting pastor, new father. And I thank the Lord for being here. I'm not a person to get up and do a lot of talking. You know, I love the Lord and I serve him in anything, but I'm not good at speaking, so I usually don't get up and say anything. But I have to say, I was on my other job, I got laid off. And I wasn't getting that many hours at her still. So she had gave me some hours at first. And then they called me back to my old job, so I went back. So she, you know, I couldn't do the hours. So then, at first she wouldn't give my hours back to me. But I thank the Lord, I asked her again, and then she did give me the hours. And I thank the Lord for that. And I thank the Lord one morning, My daughter getting ready to take the kids to school. And the Lord led me to call and have prayer with them. So I did. And my daughter said somebody like to hit them, that I had an accident. And I thank the Lord by me obeying him, wow, that they were saved. It didn't even happen to them.
Amen. We give God glory.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Is everyone good? Amen. As we continue, amen, service, we thank God for all the testimonies. Amen. We're going to continue to expect more testimonies. Amen. We're going to ask the praise team to come forth and give us a selection as we prepare to hear the dynamite speaker of this evening.
Amen.
Thank you.
God. Come on, let's clap those hands if you hear praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on. Clap your hands like you know that 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 you hear greater for your life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, our God is good. We serve an awesome and a great God. We serve a God that cares about us. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. We thank you for the greater God. Amen. We thank you for we are setting an expectation, God. For our hearts are excited right now, God. Hallelujah. For the word that's going to come forth, God. For this man is sent from Honduras, God. Hallelujah. To give us the word, God. To speak blessing in our life, God. So we speak greater, God. In our life, pray on our hearts. Pray a word, God. Oh God, we pray that you open up our hearts that we may receive it, God. Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. I'm going to ask that you rest upon your feet, everybody. Everybody that's able to stand, let's rest upon your feet. Hallelujah, as we bring forth this awesome man of God. Hallelujah. That's going to bring forth a word of resurrection for us, a revival tonight in our spirits and in our soul. In the name of Jesus. I'm introducing some of the people that will come over that are ready on. Apostle Brad in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Put those hands together and give God the praise. Why don't God give it to the Father, the Son, the Holy Ghost? Hallelujah. I say hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is a good God. And again, we are honored tonight to be in this sanctuary. Giving glory and honor to the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Honor to the chief apostle of this house and ministry. Amen. All the prophets and prophets, pastors and ministers in the house tonight. My wife, we are honored to have you in this place. Hallelujah. We are going to continue the celebration that we began last evening. Tonight, on the subject of the three greatest R in the Bible. They are restoration, renewal, and refreshing. The three major R's in the Bible. Thank you, Lord. Restoration, renewal, and refreshing. Father, we honor you one more time. Your presence is surreal in the house at this hour. Lord Jesus, we exalt you one more time. Thank you for what you've done through present worship and all the testimonies. Now, in the name of Jesus, send your word and heal those who might be sick tonight. Send your word and deliver those who need deliverance in the house. Send your word and strengthen those who might be weak tonight. Send your word and save the lost. Send your word and set the captives free. Send your word and fill the Holy Ghost in fire. Those who need a filling tonight. Send your word, Father, and bless and minister to every need tonight. In Jesus' name we pray. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Oh, you didn't say it good. Amen. Hallelujah. That's better. Be restored back to your position. And somebody said, what's that position? Heads and not tails.
Hallelujah.
You already said it. I bow only and not beneath.
Praise God.
According to Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 13. Again, I said to you, child of God, what's your position?
Yes.
You are to have dominion over the earth. According to Genesis chapter 1, 26 to 28. We began last year in 2014, the year of divine reversal, meaning that God will divinely turn around the adverse situation and
fully restore you back everything that was lost or that been stolen or taken from you. We begin this evening by going to the book of Joel, chapter number 2. Hallelujah. Joel chapter number 2. And on verse number 21. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Fear not, O land. Be glad and rejoice. Now, if you believe the word of God last night, you should be rejoicing. Knowing that God already begun to shift some things, change some things, reverse some things. Hallelujah. For the Lord has done marvelous things. Do not be afraid, you beasts of the field. For the open pastures are springing up, and the tree bears its fruit. The fig tree and the wine yield their strength. Be glad then, you children of Zion, and rejoice in the Lord your God. For he has given you the former rain faithfully. He will cause the rain to come down for you. The former rain and the latter rain in the first month. Nobody say nothing now. The threshing floors shall be full of wheat. Oh, what else we're talking about now? The wax shall overflow with new wine and oil, fresh anointing and fresh power. So I'll restore to you the years that the swarming locust has eaten, the crawling locust, the consuming locust, and the chewing locust. My great army which I set among you, watch this, and you shall eat in plenty and be satisfied and praise the name of Lord your God who has dealt wondrously with you, and my people shall never be put to shame. That's all, baby. Then you shall know that I am in the midst of Israel. I am the Lord your God. There is no other. My people shall never be put to shame. Amen. It's restoration time.
Yes, it is.
Now, we read these verses tonight. If you notice, God says, during the first 6 months of the year, I will restore back to you everything that was lost or stolen or taken from you. I feel that preaching rest about here now. Restoration time means that God is about to restore everything. Somebody say everything. I said say everything. Say everything. Everything that the devil had stolen from you, or the enemy had taken from you, or everything you lost the first 6 months in 2014 will be the blessed month of abundance and overflow, because of the restoration.
Yes.
I says restoration time. If you lost something all your life, this first 6 months in 2014, you can wait on it, because it's going to show up right at your door. God says, I will restore. Somebody go help me tonight. It wasn't the president. It wasn't the pastor. It wasn't the apostle. It was God Almighty who said, I will restore everything. I feel it preaching tonight. God's about to bring it back. Watch me. God's about to make the devil bring it back. And the Bible said, when you kiss the thief, he must pay you back several times. The thief is the devil. And tonight I make the declaration, he's got to bring it back this year. That devil is a lie. Oh, he tried so long to take everything you have. But hear me, somebody. He's got to put it back this year. The first 6 months, nobody can say no in the night. I'm waiting for June. The first 6 months, you cannot talk to them too. I'll testify. They tell me that January is the worst month in the year.
Come on, man. Come on, come on.
I grew up with that because December, we spend what we do have. It's Christmas, you see, and we've got to get this and we've got to get that. We've got to do this and we've got to do that. So they said that January, there's nothing coming in January. You don't spend it in December. But honey, when God told me on the 30th of November last year that 2014 will be my year, I said, that's it. I receive that right now. Hallelujah. I paid January bill in November. You didn't say nothing now. If you believe God, he said the first 6 months, I, Almighty God, will we, I feel the Holy Ghost in this hour. Will we still in the can I just talk a little bit? God told me months ago, he said, I am not a man, so don't treat me like a man. Because when they want your votes, they come by and offer you heaven, and you believe it. When they sit in the office, they forgot you. God said, don't treat me like that. Because I'm not a man to lie. If God said it's restoration time, you can put your neck on a chopping block. Because God said you will never be ashamed. Oh, you just missed it. You just missed it. As he went, listen, God don't talk to himself. When he says something two times, he got my attention. Because in the mouth of two or three witnesses, let every word be established. Two times in those persons, God says, my people shall never ever be ashamed again. Watch me, somebody. All your life, they have looked down on the church, talk about the church, but 10 to 14, they got to look up to the church. You ain't saying nothing. God said you will never, ever be able to talk to somebody. Your worst days. You will hear it. God will help me. I say your worst days are behind you. Because as a restoration, first 6 months of 10 to 14, God says abundance, overflow, more than enough will be knocking you down. Restoration. I says restoration time. Somebody shout restoration. Oh, God will restore your health and your wealth. Oh, you didn't hear that. It's not going to be being wealthy and not healthy. And God doesn't do halfway jobs. I'm going to talk to you for a listen. God doesn't do patch up jobs. If God will make you wealthy, that he gotta make you healthy to enjoy the way. Can I talk tonight? Make a feeling talking. Hallelujah, share King of Asama. John chapter 10. Verse 10. The middle part say, but I am come, but you will have life and have it more I don't need no abundant life in heaven. I need it here. It means a good life. You don't say nothing now. Because I got eternal life. In heaven, I won't need abundant. I need abundant life on the planet. So I can show the world that used to laugh at us and talk us down and criticize us and back up us. They say, why you go to church? They ain't got nothing there. Church poor. The devil is alive. But restoration happens to start with the people of God. If God ain't going to be restored, it's going to start in church, baby. If the nation are going to be restored, it's got to start in the house of God. Restoration. Your health and your wealth, your families, your ministries, your relationships, your communities, your properties, your authority, your anointing, everything God's going to restore.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Jesus, thank you,
Lord. Jesus, forgive me, please. As an apostle to the nation of the world, I say to you, be restored. I don't care what the doctors told you yesterday. I come to say something about that tonight. Whose report are you going to believe? Isaiah chapter 53. I come to tell somebody, I'd rather believe God or never get it. I said, well, I believe God. If I never get it, if I don't get it, my great grandchildren won't get it. I come to talk to somebody tonight. I come to talk to somebody in this house. I want you to know, baby. I want you to know, saints of God. I want you to hear me good tonight. God is restoring you back to your original position by being head. I'm sick of being tail. Tail me loose, baby. Catch me with. I come to talk to somebody tonight. God's about to bring restoration. And your family and your friends and your neighbors and your community are going to wonder, how come you're going to smile? You'll say, God, ain't nobody hear me tonight. But God's about to restore. And watch me, your help. Restoration.
Yes.
I said it's restoration time.
Yes.
Restoration time, baby. 2014.
Yes.
Lord, I love it. I said, I just love it. The first 6 months.
Yes.
In the second month, you ain't saying nothing to them. You know what I saw God did one time?
What's that?
Can I testify?
Yes. Right.
One time I just come from Mission Fields. I ain't got no money, I was broke. And the Lord said, get ready and go to Belize City. I said, but Lord, I ain't got no money. He said, you got a credit card. He said, if you wanted something, you'll use that credit card. I said, yes, sir. And I'm trusting and fighting with God. See, you never did the better than that. I said, Lord, but this meal, but Lord, but he said, by the way, take your wife with you. Since you're complaining, you better don't mess with God. When God said one time, let's get up and go, because he'll just add to the bill. You ain't saying nothing. He said, no, take your wife with you, since you're making all that fuss, just buy her a ticket.
All right.
And how many of you, when God speaks, God means what he says. Are you there, man? So I had to buy 2 tickets, my boss. I didn't feel too good about that. But we bought 2 tickets, went to Belize City, and the building we were using was too small. Had to borrow the Mennonite church building. I'm telling you, there were hundreds of people in the place. I'm telling you, God delivered millions of people in the place. God saved, God healed, God set free, God filled a lady up with the Holy Ghost. First time she'd come to the building and go back out with the Holy Ghost. You ain't saying nothing tonight. So I get home after this great crusade, and for 6 months I'm looking for the bill to pay. Hear me, somebody. I said 6 months. Let me help somebody. And the bank never makes mistake.
Wow.
After 6 months, I said, Lord, put the bill. He said, I paid that loan. I said, God said, I paid that bill long ago. God's getting ready to multiply your finances, but you got it up. You don't say nothing. You don't say nothing. God told me this year he will multiply whatever you got in the bank. Somebody hear me tonight. God is about to restore everything back. IRS is stolen from some folk, taking a lot of stuff from you. I come to tell you, God's going to multiply.
Glory be to God.
God will help me tonight. Restoration of all things.
Glory to God.
Lord, I love Jesus. Restoration of everything. When you talk about restoration, we talk about recovering all. God should never say, we gonna recover all.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you.
Now, watch this now. In Genesis chapter 14, Lord Jesus, what year is this? It's a 14 year of which millennium, the third millennium. Well, you don't say nothing now. I said Genesis chapter 14. Let's pick up the word 14. Oh God, you help somebody in this house tonight. I said, let's pick up on verse number 14. Yeah. Lord Jesus, you see what I see? I feel good now. Genesis 14. First book of the Bible. I told you just now, I said the first 6 months of the year. Oh God. I feel the fire of God in this house. You know what I mean? I said I feel the fire of God. Somebody give me some more volume on this thing because I got to talk a little bit louder. 14. Genesis chapter 14. Verse number 14 says, Jesus, Lord. Now when Abraham heard that his brother was taken captive, Lord, he armed him with 318 on train, normal service. Who were born in his own house and went in pursuit as far as Dan. He divided his forces against them by night. And he and his servants attacked them, pursued them as far as Hubert, which is north of Damascus. So he brought back all the goods. Also brought back his brother-in-law and all his goods, as well as his woman and the people. Hear me, somebody. And the king of Sodom went out to meet him at the valley of Shaveh, that is the king valley, after the return from the defeat of Shinaroah, and the kings were with him. One afternoon, Abraham was taking a siesta. Well relaxed in his hammock. In the cool of the afternoon, somebody came by and said, Abram, four nations had come up and taken your nephew Lot and his family. You talk about a mess for my family. Now I could be nice and good. You can do me what you like. But don't mess with my family. Abraham said, enough. And he said, Sarah, I'll get you later. The man got up. He said, I got to take care of my family. I got to defend these. He said, all you that go to my house. Now these were trained. They knew nothing about war. The went out against four nations. You didn't say nothing now. And the Bible says he came back with all the spoils that they had taken from other nations. You didn't say nothing to that. Watch me. He came back not just with Lot and what Lot had with him, but whatever else they had taken from the other nations. There ain't no way that prison lady on trend little fellas could win a war against four nations. That's not how the war. You ain't say nothing now. By the supernatural power of the Almighty God will put the devil to run. Your Bible says, why you shall put the devil. I come to tell you, he restored everything. Because it's restoration time.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord. I'm trying to get with restoration. I can't pass it. I'm trying to. Come see, without family, ain't no church. Without family, ain't no community. Uh-huh. Yeah. Say nothing now.
That's right.
Family is so important. God Almighty said, I don't want to live by myself.
That's
right. God got lonesome. You don't want to talk to common calf. God don't want to talk to them. He don't want to talk to somebody like him. His only son, and got him millions about billions of children all over the world tonight. Amen. You know what it is? God, number one priority with the family. So Abraham said, this ain't going like that. Uh-huh. I'm going to sit on here. No, no. But Abraham, you old. Tell me what I'm old. Clothes get old and shoes get old. Because then they went to put it on. I just don't need that alone.
Yeah.
Restoration. What's this now? You still looking at Genesis 14?
Uh-huh.
The two verses, 15 and 16. For the next 2 years, you will record everything. That's the laws. You're not saying nothing. For the next 2 years, 14 and 15, I don't know what happened after that, but I got this much from God. For the next 2 years, you will recover everything that the devil had taken from you. Everything. Oh, Lord, you help me, Jesus. You know what the Lord told me? He said, even when you were in sin, you lost some stuff because the devil took advantage. Ignorantly, you get up some stuff. God said, I'm going to let the devil bring it back in 2014. This is a little bit too much for me. Come, you don't deserve it. But I showed you last night, Abraham made a mess.
Yeah.
Gave up his wife to one man.
Uh-huh.
And God still blessed him.
Yes.
There's a reason why that's in the Bible. So it tells me, even with all my mess, God will still bless.
Yes.
Nobody say nothing tonight. With all your mess, God will still bless.
Thank you.
I'm trying to pass restoration, but no one help me, Jesus. It's time you will recover. You will understand. You will recover everything in the next 2 years. Hallelujah. You don't hear what I said? All of it will be back with interest. You you ain't saying nothing now. All of it will be back with interest. Watch this, watch this. It's like when I'm thinking now. David went out to war one time. When he came back home, he found the land in ruins. Wives gone, children gone, his men's wife gone, their children gone, servants gone, and the land is on fire. It was so bad. His men wanted to kill him. He said, look, look, look what you did. You took us out to war. Look what you gone and did. But your Bible says, David, 1 Samuel chapter number 30, verses 8, 17, and 18, somewhere around there, 19. David encouraged himself in the Lord. And said, Lord, should I run behind a rascal or should I stay? God said, go get him. You didn't say nothing now. Okay. He said, go get him. Because you will recall.
Thank you, God.
David went out and came back with everything plus the spoils that they had taken from other nations. You don't hear what I'm saying. God's going to recall you everything. You will recover everything. Everything is everything. God said you will recover everything. It's restoration time.
Thank you, God.
Everybody hearing me tonight? Is everybody hearing me tonight? Be restored by the word of the Lord. This thing restores my soul.
Yes.
David said, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I won't be afraid of anything. Your rod and your staff, the word and the Holy Ghost. You ain't saying nothing now. The word and the Holy Ghost is with me. And the Holy Ghost know right where the devil put the stuff. You ain't saying nothing now. We got the best CIA in the whole world. We got the best FBI in the whole world. You ain't saying nothing now. Minds walk with me all the time. There are two angels that always go with me, folks. See them all the time. I come to tell you, you are never alone. Touching them, you never know. I said, touching them, I said, you are never alone. Because the angel of God in camp round about the saints 24/7. You ain't saying nothing. David recovered everything that was lost. I said, be restored by the word of the Lord. It's what Isaiah said in chapter 41. Verse number 31, chapter 40. Isaiah 40, 31. He says, they that wait upon the Lord. Now let me help somebody. Because waiting upon the Lord is not sitting doing nothing. Wait. Waiting upon the Lord is not sitting doing nothing. Some folk got the bad idea. It's going to drop out of heaven. I'm going to lose to you. It's not going to come like that. Waiting upon the Lord is like when you go to a restaurant. Hear me, somebody. And you at the door, somebody meets you. And they say, table for 1, 2, 3, 4. And they say, non-smoking section. And they scold you in. And say, here's a seat, sir or ma'am. Put you at a menu. Bring you some water. And say, I'll be back in a little bit. We call them waiters. But they're doing something while they're waiting. You ain't saying nothing to them. Waiting on God, yes sir. But while I wait to sing, while I wait to preach, while I wait to dance, while I wait to shout, while I wait to serve, while I wait to say hallelujah, while I'm waiting, I'm doing something. That's waiting on God. If you're waiting on God and you serve in whatever capacity. your strength will be renewed like that of the buffaloes. Like the rams that were caught in a thicket. While you're waiting, you're singing. While you're waiting, you're preaching. While you're waiting, you're helping the neighbors. While you're waiting, you're serving somebody. While you're witnessing. While you're waiting, God said, I'll be renewed. Your strength. So quit sitting down doing nothing.
Amen.
And see where I'm going. You ain't waiting on God. No, you're not. I see you ain't waiting on God. To wait on God, you'll be doing something. Jesus said, occupy that I come. You didn't hear that. Occupy that I come back.
Hallelujah. Yes.
No, we're going to finish this restoration part. He said, I renew your power, your life. Your anointing,
yes.
Your authority,
yes.
Your ability.
Yes.
God said, I'm going to renew it.
Yes.
If you're waiting.
Yes.
I said, if you're waiting.
Yes.
Everybody waiting on God tonight.
Yes,
yes we are.
Yes, we
are. We're going to keep singing.
Yes.
We're going to keep preaching.
Amen.
We're going to keep telling the nation of the world. We're going to keep testifying. We're going to keep telling somebody Jesus is good. We're going to keep telling the neighbors, hey, God can help you. I said, that's waiting on God. And as you do that, he said, I will renew your strength.
Amen.
Now, be restored.
Be restored.
By the word of the Lord.
Well,
somebody say, I'm restored
by the word of the
Lord. Hallelujah. Jesus, we give you praise. I feel that preaching tonight. Oh, yeah. Hallelujah. Watch this, somebody. Joseph was in prison 13 years. But the 14th year, you ain't saying nothing. You could have been in hell all your life. But 2014, you're coming up. I said, coming up out of where you've been. Because now you're going to flourish and shine in the palace of the king. For 13 years, in prison for something he didn't do. Falsely accused, unjustly condemned, paid a price. That he didn't have no business paying, but he paid it. But come year number 13, that was the last time Joseph would be in prison. Because when the butler and the baker, hear me somebody, when the butler and the baker, God has a way of extending things, you see. God works behind the scene, you see. And even when you don't see nothing, know God's working. You didn't say that. I feel like preaching in this house. But you don't see nothing. I come to tell you God's doing something behind the scenes. He ain't got to tell you everything. He is God. Don't need your help. Don't need your opinion. Don't need your okay. He is God all by himself. Watch God. Now, the 13th year, butler and baker disobeyed the king and were thrown in prison.
Yeah.
In the prison, they both had a dream. And they started talking in the prison the next morning. And the prisoner said, well, there's a guy in this prison that knows how to interpret dreams. You may as well see him and tell him. Joseph listened to their conversation and said, you in 3 days, God will restore you back to your position. I said, this gives restoration back to your position.
Yes.
Restoration back to your position. And then he said, when you get back to your position, if anything you want folk to do, don't you gonna tell them, remember me. Tell them, now remember you. He said, when you restore, please remember me. Folk will never remember you. You tell them that. Make it short. The Bible is restored. Baptist position, living good, eating good. He forgot all about Joseph. But year number 14, God said they didn't get it. Now God made them Pharaoh had a dream. Watch God. And the boy could remember one word of the dream to save his life. Watch God. Now he put an order out. All my magicians, all my soothsayers, all you folks in this, you better tell me what my dream is or you're a dead man. And the butler said, wait, mighty Pharaoh, there is a prisoner in your jail who told me. He said, what are you waiting for? Go get him. Here comes Joseph smelling like I don't know what, looking like I don't know what. 13 years of life wasted, if you may. And said, listen, boy. Joseph said, wait, sir. I don't interpret dreams. Watch me, he said, the God. You see, you got to give God the glory. Yeah, you ain't saying nothing. He said, the Pharaoh, it's not my power, it's not my might, it's but the God that I serve, that God reveals the secret things. And the story is, the 14th year, Joseph is next to the king in the palace. What year is this?
2020.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Yes, I want to get my ready.
Yes.
Yeah! When you really ready, that's a child.
Yes.
I'm trying to get off restoration. Jesus will help us. Watch this. David said in Psalms 103, verse number 3, I will bless, oh my soul, and all, bless his holy name. Watch this. Number 5 said, who satisfies your mouth with good things so that your youth, your life is renewed like the eagles. That's another message. I saw a renewal in here tonight.
Thank you, Lord.
When mother said she's dead, there, I said, darling, you just won't you just start. Don't tell yourself you're old.
That's right. Amen.
Can I talk right here now?
Amen.
When I get 120 years, I'll say I'm old then.
That's right.
Yeah. I ain't settling for nothing less than 120.
Come on now. That's right.
Because Moses stood at Mount Pisgah at the age of 120 years and saw the promised land. I'm saying nothing. I've been to Mount Pisgah, and I just went 5 miles off the road.
Wow. Jesus.
Supernatural power.
Amen.
Is what manifests yourself if you believe God.
Amen.
I got to finish this thing. Oh, Lord. Jesus. Thank you. 2 Corinthians 4:16 says, therefore, we do not lose heart. Your Bible says we faint not. Even though this outward man perish, the real you is being renewed day by day.
Amen.
Somebody say something.
Amen.
Say something. Amen. I said you're renewed by the power of the word. Ephesians 4:23. Be renewed in the spirit of your mind. Change your mind. Set daily. Oh God, what a trouble we got with the mind. Set. I got to hurry. Number, the next hour is refreshing. Be refreshed by the wind of the spirit. Somebody don't get this. God said to Ezekiel, and I like the terminology, son of man, who are you? Who are you? I said, who are you? Son of man. Who are you? You're a son of man. So you're talking to you. Son of man, can these bones live? 430 years, they were scattered. Ezekiel said, only you know that, Lord. That's it, right? Now pray. and say to these bones,
oh, yes, Lord.
Hear the word of the Lord. Amen. Now there are two full meanings to that. First, there was Israel. Mm-hmm. That's going to be restored in 1948. We got the story, we got all that together. The next meaning is, God wants you to know tonight, don't care how long it's been separated. If you prophesy, if you speak, life. Because life and death. How you doing, sister? How can I shut your mouth? Don't let the devil hear you. He'll make you more sick. How are you, apostle? I'm fine. If I wake up in the morning, honey, I got to praying. And I'm making you praying, I'm all right. Watch this. Okay, the Bible said, bone that was scattered for 430 years came together. Watch this. They were the robots. They were useless objects. No life, no power, no movement. So Ezekiel said, Lord, there they are. He said, all right, one more assignment. Call the Holy Ghost. And set all wind. The south, come from the east, come from the west, and breathe upon this name. If you prophesy, man and woman of God, it could have been dead. But by the time you get too close to the Holy Ghost to breathe upon that thing, somebody hear me. Call the Holy Ghost to breathe on that family relationship. Call the Holy Ghost to breathe on your finances. Call the Holy Ghost to breathe on your body. Call the Holy Ghost to breathe on that hospital. Call the Holy Ghost. I said, if God told me, when you get in trouble and don't know what to do, call the Holy Ghost and set them breathe upon this situation. I've been putting it to practice and watch God resurrect. Now somebody said to that thing, wait, somebody said, but you gave us 3 hours, but you didn't say resurrection, but I come with it now. But you didn't get no resurrection on this prophesy.
That's right. That's
if you don't say it, you won't get it. If you won't say it, you won't get it. Call the Holy Ghost, the Ruach. That's who gave life, you know. It's in your book, the Bible, Genesis 1. The earth was without form. That was the earth that God created. Oh, something happened, baby. Oh, that's another message.
Yeah.
I said something happened. There was a Luciferian flood that caused chaos. So God's got to redo the thing now.
Yes.
And the Bible said the Holy Ghost, the ruler of God, the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the deep. And when God spoke, Holy Ghost brought everything to life and order. It is the Spirit of God that gave us life. It was your mom and your daddy. Oh, you're going to spell it, baby, son. Children are gifts of God. Your mama and your papa didn't make you. God created you, baby. It was the Spirit of God, Joseph, that put breath, life. Now you learn, when the situation gets rough, you know, Holy Ghost, come breathe on this. You can call him. As you can call him. Come breathe on this husband of mine, on this wife, or come breathe on these children of mine, on this boss woman, on this nothing. I sent for the Holy Ghost.
Yes, Lord.
And when Ezekiel called the Holy Ghost, the Bible said everything stood up as a mighty army of God. You ain't saying nothing now, but the Holy Ghost is waiting for the call so he can work on that thing for you. Money can't fix it. Judge can't fix it. President can't fix it. You can't fix it. But the Holy Ghost could. He's been waiting 2,000 years to hear the church call the Holy Ghost. I'm going to close the last hour. Oh God, I got to say this before I get to the last hour. Habakkuk, Sheremanda, Ebosiah. Acts chapter 3, verse number 19. The last hour is, your Bible said, repent therefore. Oh Lord. But I will talk about refreshing. That's what I said. I didn't say repent. Because when folk hear over repent, they don't go and judge everybody now. When they hear the word repent, and they see somebody come up here, wonder what she did now. Wonder what he did now. It ain't nothing to do with sin. It has nothing to do with sin. It has to do with change your mind, sin. Change your way of thinking. That's what Acts 3:19 said. Change your way of thinking.
Yes.
So when the time of refreshing come, was this? Because some folks still got the idea, well, can I see the house in the night? I don't know where they get this stuff from, but culture, I believe, great grandmama say, can I see the house in the night? It's by luck.
Jesus.
Nonsense. They say, man, can't wear a hat in the night? Nonsense. You gotta change. You gotta repent. Gotta go on load.
Yes, yes.
This new stuff that God, some stuff that they gave me, even in the theological cemetery. Some stuff they gave me, honey, I wouldn't tell nobody about those things to save my life. Nonsense. You're not saying nothing, I say nonsense. But since you say you gotta get this piece of paper, no, thank God for this paper. But I'm telling you, some stuff that they told me and trained me and told me, I never even think about telling anybody about those stuff. Got nothing to do with God. I say, got nothing to do with God. So we got to change our way of thinking. Because as a man thinks, I'm a child of the Most High God. Walk like it. Talk like it. Act like it. Live like it. You know, all my life they told us that we were rich. And I would get offended. Because we didn't beg nobody for nothing. My grandmama taught us not to beg. And when it's lunchtime, we even think we'll go to my neighbor's house. There are many days we didn't have nothing to eat. But nobody knew.
All right.
So the spirit says we're not begging everybody and borrowing from everybody. Oh, they got money. It would offend me. Honey, I'm about to get it.
Hey!
They were seeing some stuff in the future. And I couldn't get it then, but I got it now. Call you whatever they want to call you. Money coming, 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 money coming to me. But the cameras are here and they load it down. Now this, I got to finish this. They said, repent, change your mind, way of thinking, be converted, let your sin be blotted out. So when the time refreshing, come from the presence of God. Two conditions God said. Two. And we're talking believers. This is not for unsaved folks, this is believers. Two conditions. In order to experience the wind of the Spirit, the refreshing of the Lord. One, repent, change our way of thinking, change your mindset, and two, be converted. Now, watch this, how a child like out into them.
Child like out. Wow.
You could just scold the child, whip the child, because where I come from, they still whip you. And don't call 911 there. They'll get whipped too. Where I come from, they still whip you. They still get disciplined. You ain't saying nothing now. Because you spoil it, right? You spoil the child. Put the rod on, and he'll be walking straight. She will walk straight. Watch this. You could just discipline the child. And a child will turn around and hug you and kiss you. You tell an adult, repent. Hey, who you think you are? Tell me what to do.
That's right.
Wow.
That's right.
We got to change the attitude. Yeah. It's a stinking attitude.
That's right.
To think yourself that nobody can correct.
That's right.
Because the Bible says God disciplines. You don't say nothing. God chastens. God whips. Watch me. You ask Jonah, how he got a 40-day journey in 3 days. You just ask Jonah. The lips of God. Yeah, that's where you're buried. 3 days, 3 nights, that will heal. Oh God, I gotta finish this thing. Can you imagine just with me, just try with me a little bit in your mind. Inside of a fish belly. There's rods in there. Old pots, old pans, all that stuff is happening there. And you can imagine that stuff. It will really hit. I understand what Jonah said. Out of the bowels of hell, I cried to God. It was awful, long slime.
Yeah.
All the junk that the fish eat. And you can imagine that. But that lesson, that whooping, because if God says you're going to do it, don't wait for trouble, just go ahead and do it. Because you can get licks and still got to do it. So it's better than just do it nice and good without the licks. Because trust me, when God wants something, God gets what he wants, because he's done. So change our mindset, our way of thinking. And the children, that's why Jesus taught the lesson. The disciples, they're fussing and fighting. When you get to the kingdom, I won't be on the right, I won't be on the left.
Okay.
Folks still like that in church.
Amen.
Fighting for position.
Amen.
You know what my theory is? If you fight for it, God will call you.
Amen.
Just me. Everybody God called, they're running away from it. So when I see church folk fighting position, that ain't God. That ain't God. I said, that ain't God. Jesus had enough of this situation. He said, bring me a little child. And several laughed and say, unless you become like this child in the sense of being humble. Don't tell me to be a baby, because when I'm the child, I speak like a child. Now I grow up, I don't know. So he was trying to show the lesson. The attitude of a little child. You could just whip him or her, and they'll hug mom, they'll kiss you, whatever. That's the attitude. You've got to take, or we're not going to heaven. I'm finishing now. First R, restoration. Second R, renewal. Third R, refreshing. And God had begun the job.
Amen.
It's left to us to believe God that complete restoration is in the atmosphere. Complete restoration is on its way to biblical ministries. I don't hear you saying that.
Glory.
Get in here. I said. tell nobody else. He sent me ahead to tell you. Because your Bible said,
Behold, thank you, Lord.
How good
yes.
and pleasant it is
yes.
for our brethren to dwell together in unity.
Yes.
It's like the precious ointment
yes.
that flow from the head. She pops in the head.
All right.
yes. Say something, somebody.
Yes.
And it runs right down to the skirts.
All right.
I mean, from the head it flows.
Yes.
Everything in here get connected to.
Because
yes. your blessing. Are connected
yes.
to a place.
Uh-huh.
Excuse you. Your blessing
uh-huh.
are connected to, you know.
Amen.
I'm going to preach that one day, you know, next time. But your blessing are connected to Pinnacle.
Yeah.
Yeah. Restoration will start here. And I'm not selfish. I never been since I got saved 40 years ago. I love people.
Yes.
Especially God's people.
Yes.
And when God says something to me that doesn't make sense, I know it's God.
Amen.
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 Anytime it doesn't make sense to this brains, I'll say it because it's God. And he told me tonight, restoration is coming to Pinnacle. Now you are responsible for taking outside to somebody else elsewhere. To your family, to your friends, to your neighbor, to your society, to your community. You are responsible for taking it elsewhere. God bless you real good tonight. I pray the word of God will stir you up. Because we got two more nights with the apostle. Friday and Saturday. And Lord, you don't want to miss it. Something brand new coming up for you. On Friday and Saturday. You haven't heard this in your life. You never heard it yet. Because I just got it. So you can. But you'll be the first to hear it in America. You'll be the first in America to hear it. Come Friday, come Saturday, and watch God do exactly like he said he would the first 6 months of 2014. Restore everything. Jesus, I feel like preaching some more what happened for next time. But we love you. We're families. You didn't know what I'm telling you. And God connected us.
Yes.
And we see the same thing. We say the same thing.
Yes.
I wasn't here for months. But this came by to reinforce what he already told me.
Yes.
You understand what I'm saying? Yes. It means that God is working
yes.
by his spirit,
yes.
revelation knowledge,
yes.
and wisdom. Manifestation and power and glory is upon Pinnacle. God bless you tonight.
Give God glory. Give God glory for what he has done. Amen. Apostle Grant. Hallelujah. And we know that some of you last night, God began to heal and deliver some of you last night. But if there's somebody in tonight who has pain, and you want to have prayer, you need to come on up. If you want to stand in for somebody, you see where the anointing begins to move like this. And the Lord, amen, come on up. Because see, it ain't, I want you to trust God. Amen, God's going to move. Amen. And when you have a condition, come on up, Pastor Brent. Come on up, Ms. Brent. Evangelist, come on up. When God begins to move, amen. So if you got some pain, come on in. You see, God is a healer. He's a deliverer.
Amen.
He's a restorer. So just let God, you know, we're going to pray for you tonight. And we're going to come in agreement. Amen. That's perfect. Amen, God. Come to God. Oh, she's still ministering. 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 She's still ministering
doing something so we can wait. Amen.
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 Glory to God. For your presence, your power, your morning.
Slumping the room.
your glory.
Ta-da! What was stolen from us, God? I call back Carolina Pinnacle Studios, God. I call back the dream. I call back the vision, God. I call back the name. I call for restitution. In the name of Yeshua Messiah, I call for God. I don't want worship. The 26-story prayer tower, God. We call for the walking trails, God. We call for the amphitheater, God. We call for the Pinnacle Village, God. In the name of Yeshua Messiah, we call for movies being made, God. We call for God, studio, cathedral being built, God. Hey, a healing mountain, God. We call for God, Adonai, hotels and motels, God. We call economic development, God. We call every plan, God. What about that you've given, Lord? And the Maranatha the Bible calls, God. We call you to your promise, God. But every lie that's been told, what about my shit? We cancel it now. That you designed for me to be dead out of my shakings. We call for relationships. Double for the trouble, God. Head out of my shakings. Renew, God, within us.